Bishop Dwenger bounced back from their loss to Homestead with a 10-3 win against Carroll. The Saints' defense only gave up 3 points. They are the only team to keep the Chargers out of the end zone this year. And Dwenger used a 19-play drive to set up Hayden Ellinger's game-winning touchdown in the fourth quarter.
We always say, as a defense, if we can not allow them to score, then they cannot win the football game. And I think we showed that on Friday night by holding them to 3 points and having our offense score some points as well.
Concordia is coming off a 40-33 loss to Northrop. The Cadets were down 33-14 and came back to take the lead. But the game would go into overtime, where the Bruins sealed the deal.
I'm glad we didn't shut down at halftime. I think it was showed a lot of character that we came back. Defense did a good job holding them to no points until overtime. The offense put together a lot of good drives.
This week, the two teams meet each other at Concordia's Zollner Stadium. The Saints are 4-1, and the Cadets are 2-3.
We're kind of like rivals. I mean, since we used to play at Zollner, it's going to be a good game. I mean, they always come out giving us their best game.
Knowing that they just beat Carroll and they had a close game with Homestead, I think it would be really good to get this win, because after losing to Northrop, we got a chip on our shoulder.
Both teams have talent at the quarterback position. Concordia's Brandon Davis has the third highest passing yard total in the Summit Athletic Conference with 905. He has posted multi-touchdown games in 4 of the 5 games he has played this year.
From my sophomore year to now, I think I've gotten stronger. I've gotten a lot bigger and just becoming more of a leader. Like in the summer, that was just my main focus, to be more vocal and lead the team better. And I think I'm doing a really good job at that right now.
Dwenger's Brendan Lytle has the fourth most passing yards in the SAC with 764. He has thrown 8 touchdown passes to just 3 interceptions. But it's not just his stats that have impressed his coaches.
I think for us, it's how is he maturing. I think it's how is he, commanding the leadership in the huddle and those kinds of things. He's been doing an outstanding job. You know, he's had a few moments of adversity where, because of who he is, he's trying to do a lot of things. And we want him to be that way. We want him to be competitive. We want him to take shots. And I guess most importantly, how he's overcome those moments, an interception here, an interception there, in some moments in the red zone, and I'm most proud of how he's overcome those things.
Both teams also have great running games. The Saints continue to use multiple backs in their ground game. Louis Tippmann remains the team's leading rusher with 342 yards, while Patrick Finley has over 220 yards, and Devin Tippmann has rushed for over 180.
You can't measure how valuable it is, especially going through the gauntlet of the SAC, having guys that are able to run the ball, and we've been able to keep those guys healthy and spell them when we need to. So you can't measure the value that is to have extra guys that can tote the ball for you.
The Cadets' rushing attack is led by Amir Drew, who is the SAC's third leading rusher. Drew has rushed for 450 yards and 6 touchdowns.
I think he's getting better as the season goes on. Again, turnover bug bit him a little bit last week. He had 2 fumbles that hurt us quite a bit. He's okay, but he can be better. So we're looking for better performances yet.
Despite giving up over 20 points in each of their last 2 games, Concordia has held each of their last 2 opponents to under 350 yards of total offense. Nonetheless, with the talent Dwenger has, the Cadets will need to be at their best on defense.
I've been impressed with their quarterback. I think he does a nice job running their offense. They do appear to have a few more playmakers than they've had in years past offensively. Not particularly fancy with what they do, but just really solid and organized.
As for Dwenger's defense, the most points they've given up all year was 15 against Homestead, and they've kept 2 of their opponents out of the end zone. They'll look to continue their success against Concordia.
We know they got some talented guys. The quarterback can move really well. They got some good wide receivers. We're just going to keep playing our game. We're going to be hard up front. We're going to be hitting hard, and we're going to see what happens at the end there.
This is Thad Goff for Summit City Sports. The Cadets and the Saints kick off at 7 o'clock at Zollner Stadium.
Looking to throw once again. Straight drop back. Looking to run. Flicks it in the back of the end zone. Touchdown! Number 6, his 2nd of the game. Tyler Grossman cuts it to a 7-point deficit.
For Lytle's under center. Here's a snap. Hands off to Ellinger. End zone, touchdown, Saints.
First drive through. Just talked about that at the break with our stat man, Tony Lowe. Great call, Tony.
mix on the beat.